I'm Dr. Elaine Ingham. I am a soil microbiologist. I work with the ecology of soils and how the organisms that live in soil interact with plant roots. So working with bacteria and fungi, protozoa, nematodes, microarthropods, mycorrhizal fungi, root systems of different kinds of plants, trying to understand the beneficial organisms versus the detrimental organisms. How do we make an environment that's going to select for the beneficials and against the detrimentals? I think probably when I was working on my PhD at Colorado State University, there was a large group of people that I was interacting with, the natural resource ecology lab team. We were trying to understand what these different organisms do in soil, and especially in grazing systems. So a whole part of the NREL is very much focused on grazing. And so started interacting with them, heard about Alan Savory at that time, went and saw Alan when he was at a conference, I think the Ecological Society of America probably. What Alan talks about, it makes a lot of sense. Alan spent a lot of time observing nature, and I think he has a lot more validity than many of those people who have just taken on the academic version and not really tested and paid attention and observed. Well, regenerative agriculture can restore communities through the process of making those communities healthy once again. You have to have healthy human beings to have a healthy community where there's enough leisure, there's enough time within that community to pay attention to children, to pay attention to the old people, and not be on the edge of starvation, not being on the edge of collapse of the local economy. And so regenerative agriculture, because you don't have to constantly be putting inputs, constantly working, constantly having to minor change the when a disease comes along, when a pest comes along, when a drought comes, all these problems that we have right now, because we have not been paying attention to the soil, we have not been making certain that the base of the system is intact and whole, and therefore every step up the ladder is healthy and whole. And you know, when we have that healthy community, healthy soil, healthy animals, healthy people, then you have time to be taking care of all the important things, all of the aspects of that community. The role that consumers can play in healing these landscapes, bringing back a condition of health, is to become involved in that actual process of bringing back to the soil the life that needs to be there, starting to manage animals in such a way that they're impacting the system for a short period of time, and then moving along and making certain that there's not unremitting damage to being done to the soil, being done to the community of plants, being done to that ecosystem, so that we're not overstressing a portion of the system, which then starts to degrade. And as one part of the system degrades, it has impacts on everything else, even though we may not have directly impacted that. So the consumer needs to learn the methods of making certain that there's no overwhelming stress, no overwhelming damage done to any part. Well, then it means the consumer has to understand how ecosystems work and what ecosystem function actually is and how we manage that so it's not damaged. Research can play a role in moving holistic management along by assessing and understanding the mechanisms by which the management that's being performed is actually doing that job. We always need to understand the mechanism, exactly why does having a herd of cows out on pasture impact soil health? How exactly are those hooves pushing organic matter into the soil, and why would that generate a healthier set of microorganisms in the soil? When will that too many hooves, when does it become detrimental instead of beneficial? When we're looking at animal grazing, how long between a grazing event and then taking the animals away, how long does that have to rest before the animals come back? And if we just kind of invent a number, then we don't know for sure. We could have brought them back faster and improved productivity, or under certain conditions, what are those conditions? You would have to leave the animals off longer, or you have a detrimental impact on that life in the soil. So research is an integral part of this, but it needs to be the practicality. What do we really need to know to reach the goal of healthier communities, healthier soils, healthier plants? Those questions should be driving the research, and not the research being negative or saying something like holistic management can't possibly work, when in fact there's a lot of data showing that it does. I think the vision of everybody living in ecosystems, being part of that ecosystem function, interacting and being very well integrated into the whole system. And I think that probably the best word for living in a green, vibrant, lovely, good nutrient cycling, everything's in a condition of health, not stressed, I think that's paradise. And so that's probably really what I'm looking forward to, is being able to develop those kinds of situations for human beings and animals and plants, the whole system, to exist in those kinds of balances. The role of the Savory Institute and of holistic management plays a catalyst role. The set of information, starting this shift and the change to understanding where people work with the environment instead of against. Human beings have had this attitude of manifest destiny. Human beings are here to rule the world. We are supposed to be able to take what we need. And that's absolutely the wrong attitude. We are part of the system. We have to behave as if we're just one of the pieces working with the rest of the system. And I think the Savory Institute has that function and role to point that out, get people to understand we need to shift this attitude about what human beings are supposed to do on this planet. If you go back to the Bible, for example, the Bible says human beings are supposed to be the gardeners of the planet. We're the caretakers of the planet. We're not the almighty monarchs, and we can grab and take what we want without thought for the future. We have to be a part of it. And so I think Savory Institute and holistic management play a very important role in helping people understand that that's our role and function.